Hi, Kevin from Snowy's Outdoors here, and this is the portable camping heater from Gasmate.
Hit it.
This is lightweight and easy to handle. It has electronic ignition, and it is ideal for keeping your campsite warm. Now, this unit comes in at about 4.9 kilos. It is 42 centimeters wide. It is 24.5 centimeters deep, and it is about 35 centimeters high. You put the handle up, it is about 40 centimeters overall. The body is made up of a nylon material. You've got a steel frame here, which is powder coated, and you've got a chrome grill at the front and handle. And then you've got a ceramic burner just there in the front. If I turn this around here, you can see there's not really not much except that is where you connect your gas. That's what I'll talk about shortly. And if I turn the unit around again, you have your controller here, and I'll hook that up and show you how that works as well. On the back here, you've got some ventilation to allow the extra heat out, and you have this little flap that you open that up, and inside here is your gas hose. Now, the unit comes with this gas hose. You don't have to buy it separately. That's a regulator supply, and I'll hook that up shortly and show you how it works. So we'll close that up. Now, I'll just turn it around and lay it on its back. There's a little compartment under here where the battery goes. You just open that up like that. Take your D-cell battery. Now, this is sold separately. It doesn't come with the heater. Push that in there, all the way in, and close that back up again. Now we'll stand it back up again. Now I'm going to connect the hose to this. You can see this is the POL fitting. That part goes on the bottle. And this one is the 3/8 BSP that goes onto the heater there. So we'll screw that on. Now make sure that this is tight. You will need a small spanner. Just nip it up, doesn't have to be really tight, just nip it up so it doesn't not loose, that way it doesn't have any leaks. Now, if you smell gas, you can test for leaks by putting a little soapy water on it. You soon see it bubbling up, and that'll show you there's a leak there. What you do is try and tighten it up a little bit more, but don't over tighten it. If it continues to leak after that, then there's something wrong. There's a mark on there or something, and it needs to be looked at by a professional. So that's it connected to the heater. Now I'm gonna connect it to the bottle. I'll just grab the bottle. Now this is just a display bottle. It's a bit of an old one, but it still does the job. Uncoil the hose. You can see this is a POL fitting. That's a POL adapt fitting on there. It has a left-hand thread, which means you actually have to undo it to do it up. So just tighten that up. Now we'll just move that gas bottle around there out the way, and we'll turn the heater around. Now, when you turn the gas bottle on, the hose is full of air. So just allow a little brief moment for the air to go through the hose so it ignites properly. Now, this heater is very easy to operate with this single knob here. It's currently pointing to the off position, as you can see. To ignite this, you simply push the knob in and turn it around to the left, to the ignition position. Now, you need to hold it there for about 30 seconds. So if you keep counting, you know, 1 to 30, you can just hold it there for a little bit. This allows the thermocoupling to heat up and make sure that the pilot light stays alight. So if I release that now, the pilot light should stay on, which it does. Now on this side here, you can see you've got the igniter. On the other side there, you've got your thermocoupling. I'll show you what happens when I blow the flame out. You hear that little click? That's the thermocoupling shutting off. Now thermocoupling is a flame failure device. What happens is when the flame goes out, that device will shut the gas flow off, so you don't have gas flowing, then you don't create a dangerous situation. Now, just looking at the control knob down here, you can see it's currently pointing to the low position. Now, it's locked in that position, can't really move. Just turn it around to medium, just push it in slightly and turn it. It'll slowly go up to medium, and it'll lock itself there in medium. You go around to maximum, you push the knob back in again, turn it around until it hits the stop, and now it's at maximum. Now this heater has an output of about 13,500 BTUs. It uses about 265 grams per hour. A couple of safety features built into this heater. It has an automatic tip over safety switch, which means if you happen to tip it over, knock it over, it will turn the gas off and put the flame out. It also has a built-in low oxygen sensor. Now that means that if you're inside a tent or enclosed space and the oxygen level drops, it'll turn itself off automatically as well. But it is not designed for inside spaces. You don't use it inside a tent or a caravan. It's actually designed to be used outside. Now that's all I've got on the Gasmate portable camping heater. If you want to get any more information on this or any other products, go to our website, snowys.com.au, where we have the lowest prices every day. If you want to subscribe to Snowys, click over here. If you want to watch any more videos, just click down here. If you want to ask a question, leave a comment down below.